Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Here we'll use Goroute package to do routing in our app. So here is our main screen, and from main screen we can click on a button and we can go to a new page, and we can click button to go back to our home screen. And if we click other buttons, it'll take us to new page, and from that new page we can go to another particular page we want, and we also see the page routes, and from that page we can go back to our home page. Now this is true on the browser. Goroute is amazing. You can also run it on browser. So we see the same result. As we click on this, it will take us to page 2, as you can see from here. And if you want, you can directly access page 3 from here. So this is page 3. Remember, this is page 3. And page 3, from page 3, we can go to page 4. Let's click on this. So this is page 4. And we go to page 4 like this. So Goroute is a beautiful package to navigate in your app. Get started, come to our pubspec.yml file, and over here we are going to install these two packages. First one is the Goroute for routing, and this is for removing the hash on web URL. And here I'm in my main.dart file, and I'll create a main function. So this is the main function which takes app, and we'll come down here and create a stateless app class. And since we are going to use Goroute, now over here instead of returning a container or material app, we are going to return material app.router. So here is our material app.router, and over here at the top we have declared a title which we are going to show it at the app bar. Here it takes a required argument which is called router delegate, and this is what we are going to put now. And of course we need to supply value to it. Now this value would be coming from Goroute. Now right below it will create a Goroute object. And to be able to create a Goroute object, you have to use the constructor which is called Goroute. It takes a list of properties. One of them is routes. Now route takes a list of routes. Now all the routes over here are wrapped around Goroute. Now as you can see over here. Now at the same time, this one also has a required argument which is called path. So we'll go ahead and implement it. So here is our path argument. For now, we'll keep it empty. Now since we have this Goroute, and based on this we are creating an object which is called router. Now this router would be available over here, so we can access it, and over here we could do router dot router delegate. Now with this our error should be gone. But now after that we have another required argument which is called route information parser. So just like earlier one, over here we would do the same. We do router dot route information parser, and now the error is gone. Now what is this material app? Now material app actually is another constructor of material app. Now this is our material class over here, as you can see at the top. Material app extends stateful class. It has a few constructor. One is material app and the other one is material app dot router. So based on our needs we can use any of the constructor. And we are using material app.router because we are using Goroute and injecting it inside this constructor using the object. The object over here, we created this router object. Now this path property is very interesting because it takes the first screen or the initial screen or any screen that you want to show. You can show it over here. Now in this case, we have this slash. The slash means initial screen or the first screen. Now we'll go ahead and create a stateless class. And we created a stateless class which is called page screen one. Now if we boot up our app, what will happen? This material app.route would get called, and then it will get this object over here and initialize the routing for us, and then this first page or initial page would get invoked. Let's go ahead and run our app. So now over here we have an error as we run it, and it says that we have to set up Goroute information provider. Let's go ahead and do that. And now let's rerun it, and the error is gone. And this is our first page, which is where it says Goroute routes. And where is this coming from? This is coming from here because this is the title that we set, and the title object is being accessed from here. Now it's time to do some interesting thing. Over here we'll create some buttons, and we will click on this button and go to new page. So that would be our new route, and come back to home page. First we'll go ahead and create a new screen. So this is our screen 2, and we'll go ahead and copy them and create another screen. We'll call it page 3. We'll call it screen 3. Now, these two screens, page 3 and page 2, we want to be able to show it here and be able to click them. Now, to be able to do that, those pages, the screens, we have to register. And where do you register? We register them inside this GoRoute, inside this routes list. So here, we have registered these two routes over here. As you can see, the first one, page 2, it's the path name or the route. And this is the page where we want to go. The same is over here, page 3, and over here we want to go to page 3 screen. So over here, path refers to the routes, and these are the related pages. Now, the related pages, we have to go through a builder. So it takes every go route more like a getx get pages, but it takes additional argument where it is called builder, and builder takes a constant and state. The state itself is coming from GoRouter, which is in more in depth we'll cover in next tutorial. So the idea is, if you want to use GoRouter, first you have to create an object using GoRouter, and inside this it takes a list of routes. So routes is a list, and inside that we have to use GoRouter constructor one more time, and that one takes the actual routes or the pages. Now inside the GoRoute over here, we also have to mention the initial page. Since the routes are registered over here, we need to come to our page 1 screen, which is this one, and inside this we want to be able to create two buttons. So inside the list we have created this two elevated button. Let's go ahead and save them. Now we should go ahead and click on them so that we can navigate to a new page. So this is over here, so we are on page 2, and this is over here, we are on page 3. So our routing is already working, and now over here we want to create another button that would take us to home page, and this is our home page. Now, to be able to do that, for each of the screen or pages we need to set up the go back button or go back to previous page button. To be able to do that, now we need to come to our page 2, and inside this we can create another elevated button. So here inside this page 2 screen, I have created this elevated button. Let's restart our app. Click on this. Now here we are on page 2, and we click over here, which would be clicked based on this one on pressed button. It will take us to the initial page. Remember, this initial page, once again, we have registered inside this go route, inside this path property. So let's click on this, and it takes us to home page. Now we want to do, for page 3, we want to do it a little differently. As we click on this, actually we want to go to page 4. So let's go ahead and create page 4. Now as we created page 4, we have to register this as a route. Now to be able to do that, we have to come at the top over here. And right inside this go routes, inside this list over here, we can copy this one and put it here. And this route name would be page 4, and it would refer to page 4. Let's save it. Now let's click on this. Now over here, nothing is here. So on page 3, we need to create a new elevated button. So inside this, we'll create the new elevated button, and we have to remove the const keyword. So now let's save it, and here we see that it says go to page 4. Let's click on this. While it says it's not found, let's restart our app. Let's click on this. Now this is page 4. Click on this, and over here we are. Now how do you know that we are actually page 4 or not, because there is nothing new over here? Now GoRouter provides a convenient way to know your current route. So to be able to do that, we can simply come to our page 4 over here. Now inside this build method, actually we can get the GoRouter context and create a new variable which is called a router. Now from this router object, we can actually access a property which is called location. Now of course this location is coming from GoRouter. So we'll use this object over here and access a property which is called location, and then we'll convert it to string. Of course, we need to remove the const object over here. And over here, let's fix it. Now let's restart our app. Now let's click on page 3, and it'll take us to page 4. And as we see over here, come over here, we see that this is page 4. That's amazing. So that tells us that our routing is correct. Over here, we want to create a button from page 4. We want to go back to page 1, our home page. Okay, let's save this. Click on this, and we can go to home page. Isn't it beautiful? Page 2, go back to home page. Page 3, it takes us to page 4, and we are on page 4. And then from here, we can go back to home page. So it's working. Now, it also provides error handling. If your routes are wrong or if the routes are not found, you can handle the error. And how to do that? Now, to be able to do that, so inside this GoRoute over here, we can set up another property, which is called Error Builder. Over here, first we need to create a screen, and inside the screen, we have to send the state object. State object carries the error property. If we have error, so this error builder would get called automatically. So let's go ahead and create this error screen. Below it, inside the right below it, we'll create this error screen. So this is our error screen. Let's restart our app, make sure everything is running correctly. Now how to simulate this error? So how to simulate this error? Now do remember that from page 1, we go to page 3. So here we can just simply do like any kind of routing name, for example, 6. And let's run it. So as I click on this, it'll try to find page route. It'll try to find this route, which is called page 6. But page 6 doesn't exist in our routes over here, so it'll throw an error. And it would handle the error beautifully for us. Let's click on this. And here it says that exception, no routes for location page 4. So it didn't exist. So if you have problem or error in your routes, you can handle that using this error builder. So error builder is a convenient, beautiful way to handle the routes error. Now we want to run the same on the browser and we'll see how it works. So here is our browser app, and over here we can go to page 2 and we can go back by clicking the button. We can go to page 3, we can go back by clicking this button. We can go to page 4 from here, and then we can also go back. Click on this, it takes us to page 4. Now over here we can go to page 2 directly from the URL. So this is our page 2, okay? And then from here we can go to home page. Beautiful. Now how about this hash? So we can remove the hash. Now this is coming from the plugin that we have installed earlier. So let's restart everything. Now let's go ahead and click on this, and we do see that the hash has been gone. Now let's click on this, and from here actually we can type in directly page 4, and we'll see that it takes us to page 4. And we know that on mobile phone this title changes as page 4. We can verify it from here. Okay, so let's go over here and see. So this is page 4. Beautiful. So you can jump from here to page 2. Wonderful. So it's working. So this is a beautiful way of navigating.